Highland High School versus Thorpe High School on the Apple Bowl right here on KYVE tomorrow night at 5:30.
Lighthouse collectibles, artwork, and decor so that you may keep the legend alive. Lighthouse Depot Store and Catalog of Wells, Maine. And by the annual financial support of PBS viewers like you.
This is PBS.
We watch the news for information, but these people watch the news for excellence. They decide who wins the prestigious silver and gold batons awarded for outstanding work in TV and radio journalism. For your information, in fact, the very best in broadcast information, we're talking about the Dupont-Columbia Awards. This year, presented by Cokie Roberts, Andrea Mitchell, Scott Simon, and hosted by Ed Bradley. The Dupont-Columbia Awards. Don't miss them.
Be sure to watch the Alfred I. DuPont Awards, Sunday at 1.
Amazing grace, how sweet.
You ever think back to that first time you sang at the Huntsville prison back in 57?
Oh, yeah, I sure do. That was my first prison concert at Huntsville.
Here's what a man named David Allen Coe, just a friend, he signs himself ex-convict, says on the jacket of Johnny Cash Sings Precious Memories. It's been said he, Johnny Cash, has never been in prison, but I find myself looking at him as if he's done more time than I have. Each man has his own prisons. Mm-hmm. Perhaps his prisons weren't the same as mine, but I know his prisons have left their mark on him as surely as the 20 years I spent left more marks on me than the tattoos that cover my body.
The sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun.
Partial funding for KYVE's programs are made possible in part by KMWX Radio AM 1460, Yakima's choice for oldies, playing your favorites from the 50s and 60s. KMWX is your station for Husky football and basketball, Yakima Bears baseball, and Big Nine football and basketball.
KYVE Yakima, television, and then some.
$5,9424. This three-part set is $59.95 plus shipping and handling. Individual episodes are also available for $19.95 each.
This is PBS.
Next time on Mystery.
I'm afraid I'm looking for a missing person by the name of Lady Daphne Ellesmere. Do you know her?
She's my sister.
Lady Daphne was strangled, and then her body was dumped in the bush.
Do you know what you are suggesting?
Yes, I do.
You are casting suspicion on some of the wealthiest and most influential people in Kenya.
Mr. DeVille, ordinarily I wouldn't be interested in your private affairs, but someone has been murdered, and it's my job to find out who did it.
I should imagine everyone in this colony has something to hide, Superintendent. Even you.
At a bounty.
River of Song is a musical journey down the Mississippi. Join host Donnie DeFranco to explore the Southern fusion, gospel and rockabilly, Memphis R&B, and the Mississippi Delta, birthplace of the blues. The Mississippi, River of Song.
See Mississippi River of Song, Saturday afternoon at 1:30.
We broaden your horizons.
We know that learning is a journey that lasts a lifetime.
So we provide a classroom that's free and open to everyone everywhere.
So whether you're a kid or a kid at heart,
as long as you ask questions, together we'll look for the answers.
Who are we?
KYVE Yakima, television, and then some.
Head west on Washington Avenue towards the airport, and you can't help but notice Perry Technical Institute. a Yakima landmark established through an endowment in 1939. Since that time, the Institute has been successfully graduating students who have developed the skills, attitudes, and behaviors valued by employers in an increasingly competitive world.
And I'm not sure when parents and grandparents are talking with their sons and daughters if they've looked at where the jobs are. To get an education for the sake of getting an education can be an expensive proposition if there isn't a job or a well-paying job for the person when they complete that training program.
Keely Nelson is a Peritech automotive technology student who also works for a local auto dealer as part of a partnership between the school and the Yakima Valley Auto Dealers Association.
Well, I knew what I didn't want to do, and that helped me decide what I do want to do. I didn't want to do anything like a secretary, be cooped up in an office, or be a dental hygienist or a beautician, and so that helped me decide and pointed the direction I wanted to do this.
According to Dr. Jay Tooman, president of Peritech, the school has a clearly defined responsibility to its students and to the community.
I think that for us to maintain our place in the community, we also have to be reaching out to find out what does the community need. And when I talk about the community, I'm not talking about just Yakima, but the community at large. What is needed in telecommunication? What's needed in the electrical field? The machinists. And we need to be responsive to that. If we are not responsive to that and our students don't get good jobs, we don't really have a reason for existing here.
Peritech, with its reputation as one of the finest technical schools in the U.S., currently offers programs in automotive and electrical technology, graphics, instrumentation, refrigeration, air conditioning and heating, telecommunications, and machine technology. Jerry Stively researched career opportunities and visited several trade schools throughout the Northwest before deciding upon the machine technology program at Peritech.
And I found out that it's a one career that doesn't end. It's never dying. I mean, you always have machinists, and machinists are involved in making everything that makes the world go around.
Peritech training can be applied towards an Associate of Applied Science degree at YVCC, and financial aid is available.
We now have a foundation board, and the primary purpose for that foundation board was to look at the purchase of new equipment for the school, as well as to provide scholarships for the school. We're a private nonprofit school, so we don't have a tax base, so we're also looking at ways of providing assistance to students who do attend at Peritech.
Your new technical career may be closer than you think. Contact Peritechnical Institute at 453-0374.
On the Antiques Roadshow, you never know what they're going to find.
Like, this lamp could be a Tiffany original. You never know.
This could be worth millions. Or this could be... Well, no, this has got to be junk.
Discover America's hidden treasures on the Antiques Roadshow.
Now, this is nice. I got this, Memphis.
The Antiques Roadshow. What's in your attic?
Don't miss the Antiques Roadshow tomorrow night at 9.
Edward Hopper always comes to mind when I think about my work. I just like the light. He had a quote about not wanting to paint people gesturing and posing in front of his canvas, but he wanted to capture just the way light fell across a building. When I think about what I look for when I go out to take pictures, it's kind of that same thing. How is light affecting these little spaces that I find? I'm not real good at the big landscape, the West, the image of the West and things going off into infinity. I like those pictures. I rarely find a place that I can photograph that I like. So my outdoor pictures, my natural pictures tend to be what Elliot Porter called the intimate landscape, little details that we find when we're out walking that are kind of fascinating. And sometimes those little details tell us more about the whole scene than taking a picture of the whole scene would tell us. I started teaching photography accidentally because in junior high I was teaching all types of art. So I wanted the kids to have a photo experience. When I moved to the high school, I started as art and photography both, and gradually the photography part of it grew and grew until now I teach all photography. The reason I think I have so much fun teaching photography is because I can gradually move kids into that realm of seeing. It's making them a little bit more aware. And when they first come to me, photography to them is just a way to record something. Gradually, if they stay with it long enough, it becomes a way of not just recording what's there, but recording how they respond to it, what they see there, and how they feel about what they see. Then they move more into what the art part of it is, what lines and shapes and textures are in this composition, and how do they use that to reinforce the image that's there, or the object or the subject that's there. So I have a lot of fun watching that transition from the beginners to, you know, kids that are more advanced, and how much pride they take in finally having pictures that are more personal. Well, if you ask me if photography is an art, I think that things that are expressive, that are a response to what you see and are processed somehow and then shared with other people, it's an art. I think the artistic part of it is the scene. I think the artistic part is your response to what's in front of you and how you interpret it and then how you present it. In color photography that I do, the prints and the proofs that you get back may or may not capture exactly what you thought, so then there's this decision-making process about how that should be printed, whether you should go back and reshoot. So, yeah, what's involved in art is this, are these decisions, these connections that you're making all the time, and decisions that you have to make to get to fine-tune it to get exactly what you want. So, yeah, it's an artistic process, it's a creative process.
KYVE Yakima, television, and then some.
Belgrade under international pressure to let a top peace monitor remain in Kosovo. How new laws in China